It's a little cheating in my research, which is made of two kinds of office blocks. One with 10 professionals of La Gabriel, because I work in La Gabriel for this research. They are representing all the services of La Gabriel. And I am going to see them 10 times between the beginning of this year and the end of the year. Okay. So I have already seen them 3 times, so I can give you some of my results at the end. And I have also focus group with users of La Gabriel. I don't know how many there are. 12?
Yeah, 12.
15, yes. They are also representing all the services. You can explain if you want.
They are all adults. So
yes, yeah, young adults. And my main focus, my main topic in this focus group is to ask them about their experience of living in the center. With a professional, I want them to tell me small stories about their daily work. And in each story, I try to understand which representation of disability can infiltrate
their work.
Yes. Because my main hypothesis is that the representation of disability can be some wall between the way they work now and the eye. So my second hypothesis is that if you become aware of what your representations are, this representation can be moved. Okay? Is it clear? So, in the first time, I have a huge piece of work to do is understanding the international context. So I have to read and to make a literature review. The main problem is that it's always written in English, so I have to read in English, to understand in English, a lot of work. I will manage to do it in a few years. she agrees. So, I forgot to say what was the question of my research. So, the question is what about the eye in an institution? And I would like to help professionals and users to overcome some obstacles. That's why there is horse jumping over obstacles. So my main goal is to identify obstacles and what are the user's needs to become more and more independent and to become able to live outside the institution. And I believe that small changes in the representation of professionals will bring big differences in the way they work. So, I can tell you a few first results, because I started a few months ago. And for the professional, yeah, there is two ideas that I can share with you today. The first idea is that professional considers the institution as almighty. That's why I choose Putin, which is a kind of almighty leader. Okay. So the institution is almighty, which is a kind of obstacle. If the institution is almighty, she will prevent users from being free. Mm-hmm. You see what I mean?
Yes.
Like a supermodel. Mm-hmm. And the second obstacle is articulated to this one. The professional considers that the users are eternal children. They never be able to act like adults. They won't have the skills necessary to become independent. And they feel absolutely unable to give them these skills. So there are two main obstacles, and we'd like them to overcome with our work. With the users group, I saw them once, and they wanted to see me another time because they had a lot of things to say, a lot of experience to share with me. They were very, very pleased to understand it. Two things I can tell you, they are absolutely aware of an institution contradiction. They are aware that the institution wants them to be free, but that, that she doesn't make everything to make them free. And they are aware of the second contradiction, aware of the conflict between their freedom wishes. They want to be free, they would like to go and live outside of the institution, but they are aware of their lack of skills to become. That's all that I can say for the moment.